Our first guest is the Program Director and Associate Professor of Health Information Technology. She holds a bachelor's degree from the University of Louisiana at Lafayette, a master's from Louisiana Tech University. Please welcome Karen Williams. Hi, thanks for being with us.
Thank you so much, Amy. Nice to be here.
Okay, how long have you been working at Del Mar and what brought you to this area?
I've been here at Del Mar going on 14 years. Prior to coming to Corpus Christi, because I'm not originally from Texas, my family and I lived in Michigan for a year, but originally we're from Louisiana. It was kind of cold in Michigan. I didn't like the snow in April, so we decided to move to a warmer area, and I really love it here.
Well, that's great. Well, Del Mar's glad to have you.
Thank you so much.
Tell us a little bit about the field of health information technology, and how did you become interested in this field?
Well, it's sort of a funny story, and I tell my students this, that when I was going to school, I actually started out as a nursing student, but I saw that nursing wasn't my field. So my roommate at the time was majoring in something called medical record administration. I had no idea what that was, and I can remember asking her, "What is that?" And she said, she was explaining it to me and she didn't want to go into detail. She said, "Oh, we make a lot of money." I said, "Okay, that's for me." So most of my courses transferred into the program and the rest is history.
Well, there you go. Well, it sounds like it could be a profitable career then for somebody.
Yeah, it really can.
So tell us about the degrees that Del Mar offers in this field. We have a certificate and a degree option, and are there prereqs that you would see in other allied health courses?
Yes, we have an associate degree in health information technology and a coding specialist certificate. The coding specialist certificate actually feeds into the associate degree. So the prerequisites include anatomy and physiology, biology 2401, medical terminology, and a computer course. The computer course that is now currently the prerequisite is Introduction to Computers, but any 3-credit-hour recently enrolled 3-credit-hour course could substitute for that.
Okay, so this field kind of sounds like it takes a little bit of the medical aspects and technology aspects and kind of morphs them a little bit together.
Yes, it actually does. It's I always describe it as the administrative side of healthcare. We don't take care of patients, we take care of patients' health information. Mm-hmm. And leading into that, because of the change in the landscape of the healthcare system, everything is moving from paper record systems to electronic record systems. And so that has led the change in the kinds of students that we're seeing now. We see more information technology driven students. Mm-hmm. That leads itself to getting more male students because male tend to major in information technology. But this is an opportunity for them, if they wanted to work in healthcare, to move into the field of health information technology. We have a lot of health science majors and professionals who are interested in going into the field simply because we're moving in the direction of electronic health record systems. We have more registered nurses coming into our field. We have more health information professionals, mm-hmm, who have worked in the field for quite a while who are interested in making a career change. And so they're coming into the field of health information technology.
So they see the demand and they're going with it.
Yes. Yes.
You mentioned that anatomy and physiology and some computer courses. What would be some other courses that a student would take?
Well, some examples. Some of the courses include, because we're dealing with patient information, and so we have to understand, as health information professionals, we have to understand the patient's patient information. So courses include pathophysiology, pharmacology, I mentioned medical terminology. There's one introductory course called Health Data Content and Structure, and that introduces any students coming into the field record content. There's a chapter on legal, ethical aspects of health information, because part of what students have to understand are the privacy laws that regulate patient, the release of patient information. There's a healthcare statistics course, because one of the concepts that students need to understand is healthcare statistics, managing or calculating patient health statistics, mm-hmm. especially in the hospital setting.
Well, it sounds like they're going to be very knowledgeable of this field once they complete their graduate degree or their degree at Del Mar. So mm-hmm. what would be some jobs students could obtain with this associate's or certificate degree?
I always explain to students, because that's what they ask me, and I tell them anywhere where patient information is maintained. That include hospitals, hospice, home health, insurance companies. Attorneys even deal with patient health information. Anywhere where patient information is kept is an opportunity for those students to work there and manage that information. There are many coders now that I'm familiar with who are working from home. They're not necessarily working for a hospital here in Corpus Christi. They're working for hospitals in Dallas, Austin, but the potential for any certified coder, once they begin working from home, Amy, they actually have the opportunity to work for a hospital in Alaska, Australia, the Middle East, because of the electronic health data that they're actually coding. Mm. And so the salaries for those individuals, they're not getting the salaries here locally. They're getting the salaries of those healthcare settings that they're working for. Mm-hmm.
Mm-hmm. Sounds like a great opportunity for a lot of students.
Yes.
Quickly, can you tell us how someone can find more information about this program?
Well, they can call the Allied Health Department that is located on the West Campus. They can go to Del Mar's website. The web page for the health information technology is www.delmar/HIT, and they'll find all the information, including phone numbers, contact information for the health information technology program.
Okay. Well, thank you for sharing information with us today.
Thank you, Amy. It's been a pleasure.